What's going on, you guys? My name is Tuan Tran and welcome to my videos. Alright, so I've been doing some workouts that are getting me ready for the Tough Mudder. The Tough Mudder is a 12-mile obstacle race in the mud with 20 plus obstacles that you have to finish. And let's face it, there's nothing about this that I've done before in the sense of running in mud, doing 12 miles in the mud obstacles. So definitely changing up my training, and my goals are obviously to get a lot lighter and to work on strength endurance, cardiovascular endurance, and we'll see what happens. But these workouts, you guys can give it a shot. I mean, they work on all kinds of aspects, so feel free to try one of any of my Dirty Dozen workout challenges. And whether you're CrossFit, training for this, military, fighter, you know, a guy who's just trying, or a girl that's trying to lose weight, get in better shape, you know, obviously develop more muscle tone, these workouts definitely will give you a challenge. And the best part is that these challenges are designed just so that first you just want to finish to see if you can even do it. And then after that, then it gives you an incentive to put more effort into your training. So again, you know, my philosophy when it comes to working out is education, number one, planning it out, committing to the plan and executing it, and putting in honest work and honest effort. There are no shortcuts in life. There are no quick fixes, no fad diets. If you want real results, you have to create lifestyle changes. And the only way you can do that is proper education, planning, and commitment. All right, so this is my challenge number four out of my Dirty Dozen. This is definitely one of the tougher ones. It's definitely up there. And this one will take you quite a bit of time. So I'm gonna read out the workout itself. This workout is designed to work on arms, shoulders, strength conditioning, core, and also running speed and cardiovascular endurance. It's definitely designed for the individuals who are getting ready for the Tough Mudder in the sense of the stop and go or the run, obstacle transitions. So if you're getting ready for something like that, or you're doing CrossFit, I mean, I believe this will help you get prepared for that better. And again, if you're just looking to get yourself in a lot better shape, give it a shot. So the design of the workout is, you must first do the falling upper body rotation, core rotation, before moving on. 25 full range push-ups, meaning your chest must touch the ground. I used a half foam roller to show full contact with that each time to show that I did a complete rep. Dumbbell or barbell cheek curls. Again, sometimes when you're working out in a gym, it could be crowded or you can't get to the barbell. So you just use whatever is available and you're doing cheek curls so that you can get forearms and bicep activation. And again, this is not a bodybuilding routine, so these exercises are designed to generate fatigue and also work on a little bit of momentum, because for me, doing the Tough Mudder obstacles, there's nothing about perfect form. The thing is, either you're going to do the obstacle or you can't, period. So cheek curls are the ideal exercise to match up to my goals, and it still will get activation of your biceps and forearms. So select any weight that you want to select, and then you're going to do 25. Then you're gonna move on to either using dumbbell or barbell push presses. And again, this is to activate your shoulders. You wanna use your hips, because again, this is not a strict military press. This is a barbell or dumbbell push press. So more Olympic training. Select the weight you wanna use, 25 reps there. And the last exercise is haying body weight leg raises. So again, you're not using sleeves. You are haying from your hands, holding yourself up while doing these 25 leg raises. And again, you have to complete each one before moving on to the next exercise. After that, you're gonna get on the treadmill, you're gonna run 1 mile at 1.5% incline. The 1.5% incline is important because it simulates outdoor running. Running on the treadmill at 0% incline is actually easier than running outside. So make sure you have that 1.5% incline, complete 1 mile. Then once you do that, you will then do the same upper body core rotation, completing 25 of each of the exercises, getting your next 100. Run another mile at 1.5. Then go back and do another one of the upper body slash core rotation. Then you're gonna run your third mile, then you're gonna do one more so that by the time you finish, you have ran 3 miles, and if you have finished 400 repetitions of arm, shoulder, core, then you figure out what your time is. I was very fearful of this workout because running is, God, I hate running. I hate endurance aspects. And then to have my whole upper body, you know, jacked up with blood and my heart rate, you know, 80% or higher. I mean, it was a tough workout, but I'm happy to say on February 12th, 2016, at the age of 35 and weighing in at 185 pounds, I selected barbell cheat curls at 75 pounds. I selected barbell push presses at 100 pounds. And I was able to complete the entire ordeal in 57 minutes and 49 seconds. So I only had two goals. One, I wanted to run every mile without walking it. That was goal number one. Goal number two, I just wanted to finish. I mean, I'm really surprised that I was able to do it under an hour. But hey, you know, once I got done, finished that third mile, and I looked at my stopwatch, I was like, I think I could do it. So I went for it. So I'm very happy, very pleased with that. But again, I want to work on improving upon this because the Tough Mudder itself is 12 miles with 20 plus obstacles. So this is nothing in the sense of the duration of that. So this will definitely help me get ready. And if you don't think this, something like this won't help you lose body fat, give it a shot. I promise you, you'll lose weight if you do this challenge. Anyways, well, I hope you enjoyed that. And like I said, honest effort, honest work is my way of getting results. And if you ever feel like you want a trainer that's not going to BS you, that's not going to put you through fad diets and try to get you to do shortcut programs and try to teach you a better lifestyle and a better way of doing things so that you live the way you want to live and get the results you want to get, and it's not temporary, it's for the rest of your life, you can work with me in Houston or sign up to have me as your online coach. Either way, take care, enjoy the video, and until next time.
3 miles, 34.55, vertical climb, 238 feet. Oh, not yet. I'm close. No, you're good.